These are relatively harmless, these stress tests, right? Yes, they are. But what's the next step if you have a positive stress test? You go to the cath lab. And guess what? When they sign you up for consent to go to the cath lab, they usually will sign you up to say, look, we may find plaque in there and we may need to do a stent. So why don't you just go ahead and sign off on the stent while you're here? Somebody was talking to me at one of the webinars recently, and he said, Doc, I got to challenge you a little bit. If you're on the table and they tell you you need a stent, what are you going to do? Start quoting some doc on the internet and say you don't want a stent? No, you can't do that. And in fact, for a whole lot of people, they're already under the ether and they never wake up. They went in for a cath and came out with a stent. So why are we going where we're going? That's why we start with the stress test, what I would call the unholy triumvirate. It's stress test followed by a cardiac cath followed by a stent. And again, that gives you a false security if you think that process is going to prevent your next heart attack. The processes themselves, you could argue how dangerous they are. You know, the reality is if you look at the statistics on the dangers of getting a cath, you're putting a needle into the artery, the femoral artery in the groin, you're threading it up through a catheter going into the heart. But the reality is it's not that dangerous. Believe it or not, this will sound weird, and it maybe is, but I know of a couple of cardiologists, interventional guys, who got very curious about it, and they both felt strongly like I do that the best doctor experiences everything he or she can regarding what their patients are experiencing. Yep, you can guess where I'm going with this. One of them hopped up on the table, even though he had no problems whatsoever, and let the other guy do a cath on him. Was that totally crazy? Believe it or not, I think you could argue whether that was. But again, the cath leads to a stent. Both of these processes lead to a lot of radiation. And most of all, unfortunately, they lead to a false sense of security. Think twice before you even go there in terms of getting a stress test. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable, and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process, and that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrest.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrest.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.